Hey everyone, and welcome back to part two of our eShop deals video for this week. Now, just in case you missed part one, I'm going to be linking that up above. Also, if ever you're wondering why there's actually two parts this weekend, I explained it in the first video, but just a quick recap. With the Indie Direct sale that is on right now, there are so many amazing games that there was no way for me to fit everything into one video. So I split it up into two equal parts in no particular order. Quick reminder though, that it's always a good idea to check out last week's video as well, because I won't be going over the deals that were included in last week's video or the deals that were included in the under $5 video that we did on Wednesday. So let's not waste any more time and get right to the second part of the list. Don't forget that if you do like the content, please hit the like button. It's the best way to support the channel, and also subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Now we're going to start off today's video pretty strong with one of probably the best overall deals for the whole weekend, which is the Messenger that is currently 50% off at $9.99. This is a 2D platforming love letter to classic gaming. On top of it, first part of the game is done in 8-bit, then when you think you're done, it shifts to a 16-bit style. It is an amazing game for anyone who loves 2D platformers. Now the next game is an amazing strategy game, Sid Meier's Civilization VI. Basically, the only reason this game sometimes doesn't make my list is because you can buy the game physically for the same price, and even I've already seen it a little bit lower than this. But nonetheless, at 67% off for $19.79, you get a full-fledged Civilization game that has been very well ported to the Nintendo Switch. Only thing is, the tutorial is a little bit lackluster. Now next on our list, we have another amazing game collection, the BioShock collection that is currently 60% off at $19.99. This is another collection that I've already seen close to this physically, however, but nonetheless, you get an amazing three games out of this collection. Of course, BioShock 1 and BioShock Infinite are probably the best, with BioShock 2 being slightly behind the other two, but nonetheless, if you love creepy FPSs with heavy storyline, BioShock the Collection should be definitely on your list. Now the next game we're going to look at is Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, but on top of this, this is the Gold Edition, meaning that it has the DLC included. It's currently 75% off for $19.99. This is basically the Mario franchise that's been combined with Rabbids in an XCOM strategy shooter type game. Sounds crazy, it works fantastically. This is a game for people of all ages and that I think everyone should have on their Switch. Now the next game we're going to take a look at is Monster Sanctuary. Now this is a monster raising training game, aka like Pokemon, mixed with a Metroidvania. But trust me, it really, really works. And currently at 25% off for $14.99, it's nonetheless a pretty decent deal. But don't worry, this isn't a cheap Pokemon clone. It really has its own feeling to the gameplay mechanics and even the combat mechanics. And on top of it, it's a really, really interesting and original storyline. Now, next on our list, we have A Hat in Time, the Ultimate Edition, which is 30% off, dropping the price down to $25.89. Now, this is not only the base game, you're getting all the DLC included at this price, which is why I really think this game is worth picking up now. And honestly, A Hat in Time, for anyone who's into 3D platformers, is a very, very solid game. Now, another 3D action platformer that I'm really glad is getting a sale is Tai the Tasmanian Tiger, the remake slash remaster, which is currently 34% off, dropping the price down to $19.79. Look, I played the original Tai the Tasmanian Tiger back in the day, and I love this game. When I heard it was getting a Switch remaster, I was really excited, but I did find that that $30 price point was a little stiff. At $20, it starts to make sense for an awesome 3D action platformer featuring an Australian hero. So yesterday I said that there was another Metro game that would be on sale, and this is it, Metro Last Light Redux, which is currently 60% off, dropping the price down to $9.99. Now this is an awesome FPS game set in a really dark storyline, which a lot of people love. If you're watching this video just as it's coming out, you still have a day to pick this game up, and if you're into the FPS genre, don't miss this one. Now, the next game we're going to take a look at is Shantae and the Seven Sirens. This is a traditional 2D platformer slash Metroidvania style, and with 30% off at $20.99, this is a great time to pick the game up. The Shantae games actually don't go on sale that often. Why? Because they sell when they're not on sale. And the Shantae games are really among some of the best platformers we have on the Switch. So if you're into that type of gameplay, this is a great time to pick it up. So next on our list, we're actually looking at the last Resident Evil game that made our list for this weekend, and that is Resident Evil Zero. It's currently 35% off, dropping the price down to $12.99. This is another one of the games that I actually liked a lot, but I do want to give a fair warning. A lot of people were put off originally by the co-op style gameplay, where even if you're playing as one player, you have to keep swapping between the two main characters. Some people were put off by that type of puzzle solving. I found it really interesting for the Resident Evil series. If you're into that, give it a try. Now, the next game on our list is going to be the XCOM 2 collection. Now, it is 70% off at only $14.99 for the whole XCOM 2 game, plus the DLC pack that is almost like a whole new game and second campaign. If you're into strategy shooters, this game has to be on your radar. Is the Switch the best place to play this game? Maybe not, but the portability factor to me was a definite upside and convinced me to double dip and buy this game again. Now, the next game on our list, I was a little bit late to the party on, which was Grindstone. It was actually featured in a previous Indie Direct video, but honestly, Grindstone is a very, very, very good puzzler. Among one of the best we have on the Switch. I know I'm saying it a lot this weekend, someone called it out yesterday, but that's why I couldn't cut these lists down any more than this. Because every time I was cutting a game, I felt like I was cutting a game that are among some of the best entries we have on the Switch. But anyway, Grindstone at 25% off for only $14.99 is an awesome puzzler. I was maybe put off with it at first because it looked like a mobile game, but trust me, it is extremely addictive and extremely well done. Now, the next game on my list is the amazing Worms WMD that is currently 75% off, dropping the price to $7.49. If you're looking for a strategy game this week and you really want one of the cheapest ones available, Worms WMD is an excellent place to look at, and you won't be disappointed because it is a top-notch quality game where basically you control a squad of worms that is armed to the teeth with a variety of weaponry, and it's as simple as your point is to eliminate the opposing squad. Now, the next game on our list is the sequel to a game from yesterday, Exit the Gungeon, which is basically the sequel to Enter the Gungeon. But don't be mistaken, it is not the same gameplay style. And that put off a lot of people, but I still found the game tons of fun. It basically shifted to a 2D side-scrolling bullet hell game rather than a dungeon crawling game. But nonetheless, if you give it its chance, I find that this game is tons of fun. And currently at 33% off, dropping the price to $6.69, it's an excellent budget entry for this week. Now, the next game on our list is going to be another Shantae game, which is Shantae Half Genie Hero The Ultimate Edition. Now, look, a lot of people didn't like this game as much because it dropped the Metroidvania style and really focused on the 2D platforming style. And although it is one of my least favorite Shantaes, it is still a very solid 2D platformer. And if you want to experience this game at 40% off for $17.99, this is one of the cheapest prices that this game has ever been on the Switch eShop. Now, the next game on our list is actually the first time I'm mentioning it, and that is Panzer Paladin. That is currently 25% off, dropping the price to $14.99. This is a really interesting 2D side-scroller, but that basically has a really original premise. It has you piloting a panzer mech. Certain parts of the gameplay that are more combat heavy, you'll be doing in the mech. Some that are platforming heavy will have you actually jumping out of your mech and focusing a lot more on the platforming. Overall, really interesting concept, really awesome game. I just found it a little bit on the easier side. So if you're looking for a challenging one, this would not be a good stop for you. But if you're looking for a more easy paced, a 2D platformer, check out Panzer Paladin. Now, the next game on our list is going to be Yoku's Island Express. Now, this is a game that definitely did not get the love it deserved because it is really an amazing Metroidvania on the Nintendo Switch. And at 75% off for only $4.99, this is a game that you should really, really try. On top of it, there's a free downloadable demo. Get this, it's a Metroidvania, but with pinball mechanics. Sounds crazy, works amazing. This is a really, really great Metroidvania. Now, the next game on our list is going to be another amazing collection, the Trine Ultimate Collection, that is currently 70% off, dropping it all the way down to only $14.99 for all four games. Now, these are basic puzzle platformers, having you taking on different characters to confront different challenges. And basically, these are all pretty good games. Some are obviously better than others. Some are starting to show a bit of age. But ultimately, if you like puzzle platforming, you cannot be disappointed with what you're going to get at this price. Now, next on our list, we have Bloodstained Ritual of the Night. Now, this is a game that is currently 30% off, dropping the price to $27.99. Fair warning, when I did my physical deals video this week, it was pretty close to the same price, if not the same price for the physical edition. So you might want to check if that deal is still going on if you'd like to collect physical media. Now, this is an amazing Metroidvania. It had a rocky start on the Switch with some performance issues, but I can tell you myself, by having played it multiple times, that they have been patched out since the original release. So if you just want a really solid Metroidvania set in a almost Castlevania-esque storyline, Bloodstained Ritual of the Night is a great pickup. Now, the next entry on our list is a really interesting 3D platformer, which is New Super Lucky's Tale, that is currently 20% off at $23.99. Now, this game has a free downloadable demo if you want to try it for yourself. It's a really, really well done 3D platformer. The only thing is it's a little bit on the easy side. It's below the difficulty level of, I would say, any Mario game. However, nonetheless, very well done, a little bit short, but for anyone who wants an easy 3D platformer or for a younger player that's just getting into that genre, New Super Lucky's Tale is an excellent entry. Now, the next game is a Metroidvania that has made the list this week because of how low the price dropped. That is Dandara Trials of Fear Edition. It is a Metroidvania that took a few chances. Sometimes it worked, sometimes it didn't. It even went as far as to try to get you to use some touch mechanics, which sometimes actually, rather than adding to the gameplay, made it a little wonky. But at 65% off for only $5.24, it is nonetheless a very good entry. And if you would like to try it out, this would probably be the perfect time because I've never seen it this low on the eShop. Now, the next game on our list is going to be Yooka-Laylee and the Impossible Lair. Every time this game is on sale, it's going to be on my list. It's among my top 10 2D platformers on the Nintendo Switch. You're basically getting a full Donkey Kong Country quality game for under $10. If you need any more convincing than that, download the free demo. I am guaranteed that if you're into 2D platformers, you'll be picking this game up 10 minutes after you've tried it. Now, I can't mention one without mentioning the other. The first Yooka-Laylee is also on sale for 75% off, dropping the price to $9.99. This, however, is not a 2D platformer, it's a 3D platformer. And if you loved Banjo and Kazooie on the Nintendo 64, or you just love 3D platformers in general, once again, for under $10, you're getting almost a first-party quality game. Now, next, we have a really original entry on the list, which is Journey to the Savage Planet. This game took me by surprise. I actually didn't think I was gonna like it, and I turned out loving it. It's basically set with an FPS-type gameplay, but it heavily focuses on exploration, platforming, and puzzles. And it really, really works very well. And at 30% off for $20.99, you're getting another really great entry if you're into any of the styles of gameplay that I mentioned. Now, for the next game, if you thought I put all the 2D side-scrolling beat-em-ups in yesterday's video, well, you would be mistaken and you'd miss out on a really good one, and that is Fighting Rage, that is currently 45% off, dropping the price to $10.99. Look, I missed out on the limited runs game physical edition of this game, and I am super sad because it is really an amazing 2D side-scrolling beat-em-up game. It is amazing to play in co-op, but still tons of fun in one-player mode. And at $10.99, you are getting an amazing game for a low, low price. Now, the next game is going to be a JRPG, but a JRPG with an extremely funny storyline and that keeps poking fun at itself. That is Cthulhu Saves Christmas. That's currently 60% off, dropping the price down all the way to $3.99. This is another budget entry that if you're into JRPGs, you really have to pick up. And like I said, the storyline is so funny. I actually am replaying this game as we speak. I decided to give it a second whirl to look at some of the dialogue I missed on the first time, because by the way, you can't go through all the dialogue in one playthrough. A playthrough is also pretty quick at pretty much under 10 hours. But nonetheless, if you're into JRPGs, this is an amazing budget entry for this week. Now, the next game on our list is an awesome FPS game, Bulletstorm, the Duke of Switch Edition. An FPS, you can play as Duke Nukem, you know I'm gonna be there. And basically, Bulletstorm is nonetheless an over-the-top FPS game that is tons and tons of fun. Is it one of the most serious ones on the Switch? Definitely not, but it is nonetheless an excellent time to pick it up when it's only $11.99 because it's 60% off right now. Now, the next game on our list is actually one that I'm also including because of how low the price got, and that is Scully, that has dropped by 70% to $8.99. This is actually a really interesting game because it is a platformer that uses rolling mechanics and rolling physics. It is really some original gameplay, and even every now and then, you'll basically jump into a body and gain new abilities, but trust me, it's actually a really decent platformer, especially when it drops under the $10 price. Now, we only have a couple of games left on today's list, and the before last is going to be Rhythm Fighters. That's currently 30% off, dropping the price to $11.89. I actually have a full review of this game on my channel. You can check it out. It's basically a rhythm-based 2D side-scrolling beat-em-up, but it works fantastically as long as you can get the rhythm down. And it really rewards someone who takes the time to invest in learning the rhythm of each stage. Oh, and did I mention on top of it, it's a roguelite, meaning you'll never start with the same stage from one playthrough to another, and you generally will not be finishing this game in one sit-down. Now, I know I broke my no under $5 rule a couple of times in this video, and we're gonna end by breaking it one last time with Dogurai, that is currently 60% off, dropping the price to only $1.99. Look, I love Game Boy style games, and Dogurai is among the best. It's a 2D side scroller action game. I would say heavily influenced by Mega Man, but rather than shooting mechanics, you're controlling a dog samurai with a sword slash. Only thing, very difficult game. If you're not in for the challenge, I would say skip Dogurai, but if you like old school retro challenging games, Dogurai is among the best. I could not include this game on my list. So that's it. We're finally at the end of this two-day adventure with over 60 games on our list. And if I'm totally honest, I know that these lists could have been even longer. We could have easily added another 10 to 20 games to this list, but at one point I had to cut somewhere. But don't worry, I'm pretty sure that those deals will be seen them again, and they'll eventually be featured in other videos. So don't worry about missing out on any of them. So for anyone who's watched both videos or even just one of the two, thank you so much for watching. And don't forget, as I said at the beginning, that if you do want to support the channel, the best way to do that is to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when all my future videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.